And now that I have your attention, I'll begin. Welcome. As you know, this entertainment is called Dispatches from Elsewhere, a title I assure you will have more relevance as the story progresses. Unless this is your first experience with a limited run episodic, which our records indicate it is not, then you're aware of the storytelling convention, which dictates that the filmmakers spend an unnecessary amount of time to introduce you to the protagonist, his occupation, the particularities of his life, and most importantly, the obstacles which stand in the way of his happiness. As the first of my many gifts to you, my friends, I propose we skip this convention and get on with what you came here for, the story. I propose I return to you 20 minutes of your life by reducing the standard introduction to a mere 2 minutes. This is Peter. Think of him as you. He is you if you lived alone and woke every weekday to your iPhone alarm still set to the default chime, Radar. Peter is you if you walk to work in the morning, which he neither enjoys nor does not enjoy. He never makes eye contact with his fellows and assumes his fellows never make eye contact with their fellows either. Peter is you if you worked a reliable job at a company which offers on-demand listening of over 2 million songs for a modest monthly fee. In addition, the company's innovative algorithm conveniently informs you of songs you will enjoy based on your prior listening history, saving you the hassle of unpleasant and unnecessary musical exploration. Peter is you if you walk the same route home as you did to work, only, as I'm sure you understand, in the opposite direction. He generally stops into his corner bodega to procure dinner, which often consists of packaged sushi with a small packet of brown liquid salt and spicy green putty. Peter is you if you ended your day in the same place you began it, with no change. Every day like the others, with the exception of meaningless and arbitrary deviation. Burrito instead of sushi, perhaps. And this is tragedy in its most quietly devastating costume. A life without risk. A life without real pain. A life without real joys. This is existing, not living, at least in my philosophy, and at the end of the day. That's all I've got. So my friends, I think we've got the idea. Now you know Peter. Squint your eyes, and Peter is you. Enough so at least, that I think we can jump right into the day something changes. I should like to confess now that I lied to you once and only once during my introduction. I can assure you, however, that I remain a reliable narrator.